The answer is only the second one is true. So the first answer is not true. In fact, the EKA protocol is designed primarily with this goal of not being vulnerable to offline dictionary attacks. And the reason for that is if you look at the two messages that are sent, the value that's encrypted with a password is the result of a Diffie-Hellman exponentiation. If we believe the Diffie-Hellman assumption, that's indistinguishable from random. An attacker who intercepts these messages could try all possible passwords in the dictionary. Even if one of those is correct, the attacker couldn't tell which. The attacker obtains the encrypted messages, which are these Diffie-Hellman exponentials. From those, there's no way to obtain the key, so there's no way to know if the guess was correct, and it should be indistinguishable from any other guess. So that's a good property. It also satisfies this other property, that it is actually not vulnerable to the meet-in-the-middle attack that Diffie-Hellman was vulnerable to. Because in this case, if the attacker tries to relay something without knowing the password, that will lead to some other key being computed, not known to the attacker, and the attacker won't be able to set up the middle attack. The main drawback of this protocol is it does require the server to keep the password. In order to decrypt this message encrypted with the password, the server needs to use the password to do decryption. So this means the server would need to store all the passwords in clear text. This is highly undesirable. If the server was compromised, all the passwords would be lost.